When you're traveling around Australia searching for uncrowded waves, you've got to be willing to get off the beaten path. Come along with world traveler Carwyn Williams on an adventure into the unknown. When he's not competing professionally, Carwyn spends all his free time looking for secret spots, and more often than not, he finds what he's after. Together with Greg Anderson from Narrabeen and California's George Hulse, Carwyn and the boys take a good long look at the conditions before venturing out for a wave. Right now it's low tide, but this shallow reef should soon enough be plenty makeable, and anyone who knows Carwyn will tell you he's not one to sit around on the beach. The mystical qualities of this spot are very real, for the break borders a large Aboriginal reserve. Overhead, sea eagles fly, and really, the only thing missing is a hot goofy footer to complete the session. Later this day, as Carwyn and Greg rested, we were joined by the elusive Mr. X, who showed up 3 hours late, but ready for action. Glen Winton puts his heart into every session, and it was great that he finally made it.
Bye.
As the sun was going down in the late afternoon, Carwyn clowned it up for the camera, and we felt lucky to have scored such a fun day of waves. Oahu isn't normally the place to go to find secret spots in Hawaii, but on this day, with the tide and swell just right, Ben Severson and many of the world's top bodyboarders had one of the island's newest and most feared barrels all to themselves. Mike Stewart's wave judgment in Hawaii is rock solid, and you won't find him going for it on just any wave. This break features a razor-sharp coral reef 2 feet underwater, and a wipeout here can make medical treatment a necessity. An important part of surfing is the search for uncrowded waves, and when you find them, the reward is oh so sweet. Mike and Ben have been leading professional bodyboarding for the past 6 years now, but no contest can match the exhilaration of an epic, uncrowded new spot. Ben can make a 360 or barrel roll appear deceptively simple, but bodyboarders can and do get into positions on a wave that surfers only dream of. Check out Mike Stewart's tube ride on this wave, and you'll see what I mean. Sean Munro is a young surfer on the move. Only 19 years old, he is one of Down Under's most promising new talents and an absolutely fearless competitor both in Hawaii and around the world. Shown here, surfing in his own backyard around Ballina, Sean's futuristic tracks are real attention grabbers. Though he obviously still has a lot of fine-tuning to do, Munro's style can be seen as an ongoing progression. There's a green plaid jacket on the back of the chair. It's like a moment frozen forever. Yeah, Mom and Dad had a lot of big plans for them. The man, so proud. Mama's gone crazy, clues the babies put down by some teenage cop. Say, worn out of bounds. It was the wrong place, wrong time, wrong end of a gun. Fun! Like another great surfer named Sean, Munro has already begun making a name for himself on the North Shore. Every surfer dreams of finding a classic beach with waves barreling off both left and right. For George Hulse and Greg Anderson, their dream is about to come true. For the next 3 days, we surfed these epic conditions with only the odd dolphin and occasional local to make things interesting. George reckons this is better than Huntington ever gets. But then, the west coast of Australia is full of waves like this, just waiting to be discovered. There's a fire beneath my skin. There's a fever that makes me ill. Got a love that kills. I got 24 hours to live. Come back. I'm begging you, please come back. Come back. afternoon of day one, as so often happens, the outgoing tide and offshore winds seemed to kill the swell, but George made the most of the leftovers. As day three dawned, we couldn't believe what we saw, and as if our luck hadn't been good enough already, the swell actually increased. Rock pile is one of the North Shore's least often ridden waves. 50 yards down from off the wall, it is an extremely dangerous reef break, located just off a man-made groin. This rock pile kicks up some nasty currents and riptides, and it's definitely for the experts only. Tom Carroll, Martin Potter, and Ross Clark Jones were only a few of the big names out on this rare day, when, for a few hours, rock pile was the best wave on Oahu.
Don't you know?
As quickly as she turned on, Rockpile lost her form, and for the rest of the winter, few people ventured out here. Three of California's best big wave riders are Chewy Reyna from Oceanside, shown here at Sunset Beach, Bud Lamas from Huntington, and Ventura's Davey Miller. Bud was a pioneer of the aerial, but few guys are willing to try making them at Backdoor Pipe. Davey's an excellent artist and a certified wacko in all size waves. Well over 6 feet tall and weighing in at close to 200, Davey's straight-up style is pure poetry in motion. Shown here ripping Haleiwa, Chewy is a dominant force whenever the surf hits 8 feet. If you could walk around the tip of Kaina Point, you'd be at this break in less than 20 minutes, saving you the tortuous one-hour drive each way from the North Shore. Formerly a locals-only surf spot, well hidden from view on the West Shore, it has recently attained more popularity and exposure. Surrounded by deadly lava cliffs, the paddle out must be well-timed and quick to avoid disaster. Brock Little and friends enjoy the camaraderie and peace of a Makaha afternoon. Here, being a surf star means nothing, and the locals enjoy the lack of crowds. Johnny Boy Gomes was born and raised on the West Shore, and he's proud of it. It's places like this where the term heavy local takes on fresh new meaning. Johnny Boy's tube riding act is so polished that he only comes out occasionally for a breath of air. Garrett McNamara, Liam's older brother, is also a versatile and accomplished rider, and like his sibling, a damn good tube rider. Tahiti's Vetea David has that perfect sense of timing that allows him to make barrel after barrel, but then so does Simon Law. Hoodoo and Simon are two surfers definitely on the move this year, and both are contenders for top 16 spot. We'll leave the West Shore now and head over to a very similar wave known as Velsiland. At V-Land, even the grommets act strange, and it's not surprising, because the wave here is so good, it's crazy. Young James Labrador pulls off a nifty floater, and Poto styles inside yet another filthy North Shore barrel. James Labrador is the latest kid on the block at V-Land to continue the tradition laid down by Larry Bertelman and the great Buttons Kaluio Kalani. Rocky Point is the proving ground for nearly every pro surfer. Only here can you find 50 guys in the water and another 50 on the beach filming every move. While Pipeline can maul you and Sunset shake you to your core, Rocky Point's crowds are legendary. Everyone complains, but there's no escaping reality. It's still one of the best performance waves there is. Just ask Bryce Ellis.
Hang around like your lonely friend.
Like America, you can like him or leave him, but one thing's for sure, Johnny Boy is here to stay. He's the epitome of pit bull tenacity with a dash of the larrikin thrown in to spice things up. Is he really as bad as he's made out to be, or is it all just part of his bad boy image?
Woke up this morning, I've done it again. I've been a hooligan on Heineken. Look in the mirror, better put on my shades. Don't want no one to know who I am. Slam bam, record man. I try to be the best that I am. Nags me, says I'm living in sin. I'm trying to drown out all of my pain. I know I'm ugly, I was born that way. If you like, we'll get it fine. Sore knuckles, another black eye. Once we're done sorting him out, well, drink them all down, drink them all down.
Leon McNamara has quickly advanced to being one of the pipeline's premier tube riders. He's got a fair way to go to catch up to Derek Ho, but he's willing to put his life on the line trying.
Yeah.
Last winter's final bodyboard event took place under cloudy skies at the pipeline in early January. Ben Severson wanted once and for all to show up Mike Stewart, and their rivalry took on fierce new perspective. In the final tabulation, it was Mike Stewart once again, as he easily won his sixth straight world title. For the first time in over 5 years, North Narrabeen was the site for the Coke Classic in Sydney. All the hoopla and excitement of the contest was drowned out momentarily by a week of non-stop rain, and the weather forecast for the last 2 days wasn't very optimistic. But, as fate would have it, Sunday morning dawned with clearing skies and a solid 5-foot swell was pounding in at Narrabeen. Barton Lynch sampled the high tide lefts, but the real action was down the beach at Car Park Rights, where local hero Brett Warner pulled into some heavy sand pits. One of the sideshow events this year was a longboard competition featuring many of the world's best mal riders. Reese Patterson from Redondo Beach showed a lot of class, but it was the evergreen Nat Young that was the crowd's favorite to win. Nat's timeless drop knee turns and nose rides are absolutely amazing. It was Newcastle's Marty McMillan's turn to upset Nat this year, however, as he finessed his way to victory. The last heats of the Coke Trials got underway early Saturday morning, and nothing could knock these guys off their boards. The level of surfing throughout the trials was simply world class. Rod Kerr from Bondi was especially impressive. If you're from Brazil and you surf like this, they call you a clone. But Mike Rummelsey from Avalon showed why many consider him a protege of Tom Curren. Mark Sainsbury had been called for interference on his first wave when he made this insane double floater and gave the judges a piece of his mind. As the day advanced, so did the crowd, and by the start of the main event, every seat was taken. Damian Hardman began his onslaught to the final with a second round win. Western Australia's Dave McCauley reveled in the overhead left, but failed to advance. Robbie Bain and Rob Page dueled it out, with Bainey just getting the nod on his final wave. Tom Curren was beside himself with glee. The surf was tailor-made for his loose, cruisy attack, and no one was hungrier for a win than Tom himself. On this wave, Curren earned 28.5 out of 30 points possible for a string of maneuvers so committed, so on edge, and so powerful that the crowd went berserk. Derek Ho seemed to think Narrabeen was a chocolate version of his beloved pipeline. He continuously disappeared in the dark chambers, always to emerge victorious. Robbie Bain's heat against the giant killer Shane Powell was another close call for Bain, and he was lucky indeed to make it past the young firebrand. For me, one of the best heats of the final day was Tom Carroll against Vetea David. Tom was really firing, but the big Tahitian can never be taken for granted. In the end, Hoodoo took one chance too many, and that's never wise against Tom. Damian Hardman continued to advance with a narrow win over Derek Ho. His next round against Tom Carroll proved to be the most controversial heat of the year. After Tom's opening wave ended in a shore break closeout, Damian slowly built a small lead, and with minutes remaining, Tom needed only an average wave to win. Taking off on a small inside barrel, Tom appeared to win the heat, but way back in the whitewater, Doma had stood up and a mandatory interference was called on Carroll. Most thought this was really Mickey Mouse. The final saw Damian against the new crowd favorite, Robbie Bain. And Bain was not about to disappoint his fans. Milking each wave to death, Bain never let up on his mission to destroy Hardman. Damian really powered on his final wave, and it was now up to Robbie to snatch a victory. Bain's final tube was short but oh so sweet, and good enough for his first $20,000 payday ever. Tom Curren's miraculous return to form this year shouldn't really be a surprise to anyone. Tom is easily the best competitive surfer since Mark Richards and may well be the first surfer ever to win back the world title. His three consecutive wins starting the new ASP season demoralized his opponents, and continued success in France saw him sitting pretty at the top of the world ratings in early September of this year. Even in the junkiest of conditions, Curren powers through the flats, carving beautiful arcs all over the wave. One kink in his armor, it's been his inability to win in Hawaii. And it's funny because Curren's style is just as clean and polished here as it is in smaller waves. Surfing pipelines hard enough without a helicopter buzzing overhead. Here, Curren angrily tells a pilot to buzz off. Tom has already guaranteed himself a position back in the top 16 this year. And if he really wants the world title, it's pretty obvious it's his for the taking. If you head east or west from Bells, you're sure to discover some excellent waves. This setup of reefs is called 13th Beach, and hollower waves are hard to find in Victoria. What is it you want from me? There isn't much I will not do. If it's only come from me, you know I might need that too. Won't you come anytime? I'm the man of many. Come anytime. I'll await your pleasure. Nothing's new beneath the sun. Put you to every sacred cow. Tell me all the things you might have done. Just tell me what are you doing now, right now. Come anytime. I won't give you pressure. Come anytime. I can't wait forever. And if you can't make up your mind, we could make it up together. Two hours west of Bells, the rugged Victorian coast juts out irregularly, and many of Australia's best big wave spots lie here. Here's Carwyn Williams again, proving once more that secret spots are there for the taking if you're just willing to look. Shane Powell, like Shaun Munro, is an excellent example of the incredible depth of young talent Australia is now fostering. It's bizarre, really, that Shane has popped so quickly into the limelight down under by defeating world champ Martin Potter and Shane Horan before narrowly losing to Rob Bain in the quarterfinals of the Coke contest. Coming from the New South Wales Central Coast, Shane has had the opportunity to surf many uncrowded days. He rips, and he seems very unfazed by the heavy pressures pro surfing can exert on a teenager. Shane's backhand is as strong as his front side surfing, and it was this strength that earned him a fifth place in the Coke Finals. The future of our still young sport looks bright indeed, and with all the unexplored islands and rugged coastlines of the world, there's still heaps of secret spots out there to find. So what are you waiting for? Get your button gear and start looking. We're only limited by our imagination.
Cause we want it, we see when we want to, and we cry when we can't choose. It's written in our place eyes, nothing comes from nothing. The poets aren't the first to satisfy their thirst. And now yes, it's over,
it's over,
it's over,
it's over.
The new age is here. Oh, now let's all make it clear. Oh, it's over,
it's over,
it's over,
it's over.
The new age is here. It's written in our place. Nothing comes from nothing. The poets aren't the first to satisfy their thirst. And the maker, yes, he made it. And we're here cause we want it. We see when we want to, and we cry where we can't choose. And now let's all make it. Oh, it's over,
it's over,
it's over,
it's over.
The new age is here. Oh, now let's all make it clear. It's over,
it's over,
it's over,
it's over.
It's over, the new